Use this play in the red zone to convert more two-point conversions and touchdowns. Coming up next. This is Full Game Prometheus, the only YouTuber that shows you full games of all the tips and schemes I post on my channel. I'll show you the good, the bad, and the ugly. All right, so guys, if you're new to my channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button, also that notification icon so you can never miss an upload. So once again, we're going to be back in the Raiders playbook, and I'm looking for a play that I can use down in the red zone that I know I can score with confidence and actually go ahead and have some way to attack my opponent with different types of covered shells that he'll use down in the red zone. So we're going to be taking a look at the tight slots formation, and you can find the tight slot formation in the Ravens, the Browns, Dolphins, Jets, and also the Raiders. So five different playbooks: Browns, Ravens, Dolphins, and Jets. And it's got a unique play called Aggie, which allows you to attack your opponent in two different areas of the field, or actually three different areas of the field. It's very difficult to cover, so he's going to have some kind of a scheme. So it's a great play to go and jump into against your opponent down in the red zone, preferably inside the 5 yard line to the 2 yard line, because this is where this play is going to work the most effectively for you. So once again, it's going to be the gun tight slot open, and the play we're going to use is Aggie. Now, a common coverage that people use down in the red zone is going to be cover two, and this play specifically goes ahead and blows up cover two. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is I want to go ahead and try to make sure the ball is off in the left hash, as far as off the left hash as possible, because it will be more effective. So one of the things I'll do is I'll come out of Aggie right away. I'll do an inside zone and try to just run the ball in. And a lot of times you can actually go ahead and get yourself a touchdown just by running the ball in with the inside zone. So that will give you an opportunity to go ahead and get an easy touchdown. So what's cool about this particular offensive red zone offensive set is that you run him once, and then you know huddle and try to go ahead and have him attack with Aggie the next time, so you really don't have a lot of time to set up an elaborate defense down in the red zone. Most people are using zone down in the red zone, but you know, obviously if you can get a cheap 5 or 6 yards down here to get the ball a little bit closer, that's going to help you. So that would be the first thing I'm going to do before I actually go into this passing play. So let's go ahead and take a look at the passing play now and why this is such a great play. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and take Gronk and actually put him on a curl route. That's going to be one of those routes we're going to go ahead and attack our opponent with. Another thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take Brown and do either an out route, or I'm going to put him on a curl route too. Now, my action off to the right-hand side is going to be very interesting. Allen is going to get wide open. Jones is going to pull defenders over to him, and you're going to have Gurley going on the wing route. Now, the wing route will get separation against cover two, but you have to throw it correctly, or you're going to get the guy out of bounds. You're not going to get the kind of animation. So right there is an opportunity where you can attack your opponent. So I'm going to show you an instant replay what I was looking at when I'm attacking my opponent off to the right-hand side. What I'm doing in here is this three route combination is going to give me an opportunity to get in the red zone. I'm watching this corner right here to see what he does and see if he actually plays this wing route. If he comes down and plays a wing route, I know that this guy is actually an easy pass lead down for an easy completion, because there's not going to be a defender that's going to come and swipe that. So just do a pass lead down, and you should be able to get an easy touchdown with that. And I've done that before in the past while using this play down in the red zone. You want to go ahead and take Brown and move him out of the way, you can definitely do that. An easy thing is just to go ahead and leave him on his little corner route that's going to pull the defender out of the area, and then you can actually go ahead and just pop him with that inside zone. So that's a route that you can always come back to with confidence in those type of situations where you need to go ahead and pop him for a touchdown. So a little out route right there. And you can see that pulls the defender out a little bit further out when you do an out route. So going back to the other side with the running back route, see how this defender actually gets pulled out of the area? That's my next read right there. And the reason we want to have that let the ball off the left hash is that we want to make sure this guy has enough running room. So watch, I'm watching this defender right here. I'm watching what he does. And see, he kind of pulls in, and he's playing this hitch route. So this hitch route is covered up, but he doesn't come out to this route. And by the time I get rid of it, he's just running into the red zone for a touchdown. So there's no way he can use her these different areas of field. If he has to respect this route on the back end side with that curl route I didn't set up, and then he's also got to respect this route right here, and then the little wing route, it's going to be very difficult for him to stop that. So basically cover three is going to be the same type of a scenario. And now it actually opens up even more for that little inside pass lead. And also with cover three, this route is going to get naked in the back end side for a nice high ball. So what about cover four? Well, your little hitch route is going to be wide open, but this route is actually going to get separation, so you can drop it down and cover four. So this is a really good play to go and jump into down in the red zone. I can tell you this much, it doesn't work as good when you're a little bit further out, primarily because you can't get to the back of the end zone. You get a little bit more shallower, so you want to stay within 5 yards. You know, obviously you could drop it down to that route to actually go ahead and get a little bit closer to the red zone. But if you're trying to punch it into the red zone, my recommendation is you want to do this basically from the 5 yard line in. That's going to give you the kind of separation that you're looking for. So even though I was able to put it in right there with cover four. So once again, my subscribers, thanks for support, guys. If you like this type of stuff, make sure you smash that like button. I'll be rolling out more Madden tips every few days, Mondays, Wednesdays, and then some gameplay on Fridays. So once again, thank you for your support, and until next time.